Bryan Johnson is determined to live forever or die trying and is putting his vast fortune and own body on the line to achieve it. The tech genius is worth $800 million and has pledged almost every cent of it to uncovering the secret to eternal youth. His groundbreaking experiments have excited scientists around the world. But more than that, he may have found the secret to a whole range of things, from permanent weight loss to maintaining flawless skin and the one food that all of us should eat to live longer.
It may not be the case that we can assume inevitable death anymore.
Well, they always say there's only two things that are inevitable, right? Death and taxes.
Exactly. And I'm saying that right now it is a reasonable thing for, not crazy, reasonable thing for one to say right now in the year 2023, death may not be inevitable.
So how far would you go to beat Father Time? It's a critical question when you meet Bryan Johnson, because he's a bloke on the extreme end of anti-aging. I'm going to his home in Los Angeles, ironically, one of the world's worst cities for pollutants, but that's not stopping Bryan from spending millions of dollars trying to become the longest living human on the planet.
I'm just kidding. Come on in. I've been waiting for you. Welcome.
To suggest death may not be inevitable sounds like the stuff of make-believe. But if anyone can discover the cure to eternal life, it's Bryan Johnson.
We're going to quickly close the door. I maintain air quality inside the house to a pristine level. And in Los Angeles, air quality is sometimes compromised.
The 45-year-old tech entrepreneur spends $2 million a year on anti-aging experiments, using his own body as a real-life test dummy.
Bryan.
How are you?
How are you, Liam?
Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Welcome.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Yep.
You're making me feel unhealthy already. Take a seat.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I'm wondering if I'm meeting the healthiest Californian on Earth.
Why would it be constrained to California, and why Earth?
Well, good question. According to your data now, how fast are you aging as of this moment?
Slower. I'm accumulating aging damage slower than the average 10-year-old. And so most people don't realize that a body accumulates aging damage throughout the entire life. And the older a person gets, the more the damage increases and then it compounds upon itself. And so you really want to slow your aging as much as possible. So one way to say it would be, I get September, October, November, December for free every year.
So every year you've got 4 months up your sleeve.
Exactly.
And that's aging at the same rate as a 10-year-old.
Slower than the average 10-year-old.
Without the tantrums.
Yeah, and slower than 88% of 18-year-olds.
We have a real treat for you today, Bryan Johnson.
In his former life, Bryan was a tech entrepreneur. And when he won big by selling his company, Braintree, to Amazon for $800 million,
tech entrepreneur Bryan Johnson,
he was free to do whatever he wanted to do.
He's spending $2 million a year on a team of 30 doctors
to reverse aging.
Whoa.
But instead of traveling the world, drinking the best wines and eating at five-star restaurants, he chose a lifestyle some would describe as being stricter than a monk, all in the name of longevity.
Your skin tone is amazing, if I may say. Mm. Like it has a sort of a translucence about it. Mm. I'm just wondering if that's a product of all the things you're doing, or like cosmetically, or just internally, or maybe it's both.
Yeah, maybe it's both, yeah. Yesterday, you can see this, I had, my skin is all beat up. This is from this device right here. So you take this device. We used a 550 nanometer filter. You run it over the body, and you just stamp it out, and it leaves these little marks. These guys will go away in a few days' time, but it basically pulls out all the discolorization of the pigment. And then there was a study done showing that it changes the genetic expression. So it tells your genes behave more youthfully. And so this was shown in a scientific study when they looked at a biopsy of the genes. You basically turn them back in time, made them acting younger.
Well, there's not an ounce of fat on you, but that's a product of the diet and the exercise. But you have to eat the same thing every day, Bryan.
But here's the thing. I would wager if we could measure our level of fulfillment from the things someone eats and what I eat, I would wager I experience more joy than they do.
Why do you say that?
I'm on a caloric restricted diet. I eat fewer calories than would be recommended for me. I appreciate food with a level of intensity I've never had in my entire life. I savor every bite. I've never valued food more in my entire life.
With a team of 30 doctors behind him, Bryan Johnson has developed a program he follows with military-like precision. It's called Blueprint.
I'm not training to become a triathlete. I'm not training for a marathon. I'm not training to become a bodybuilder. I'm not training to be dropped into the forest and fight a wild animal. For the past few years, I've been endeavoring to build the world's best anti-aging protocol. In thinking about longevity, you can pose a variety of questions. You can say, do you want to live forever? That breaks the human mind. Humans can't think about it. So when they can't compute it, they automatically reject it. Like, I don't want to live forever because I'll be bored. And like, they'll come up for reasons to justify death. But if you pose a question and say, do you want to live tomorrow? You probably have things planned tomorrow that you're excited about. Most of us do. I don't think I personally am going to solve aging, but what I think I'm trying to do is to change the culture around aging. And that's why I make everything available for free. Anybody can do Blueprint. I've made all my data, all the recipes, all the protocols, everything's available for free for everybody.
So you're not trying to make money out of this?
No, I'm trying to change the zeitgeist for humanity to say, you know what? We want to live and step into this future.
All right.
Blueprint is definitely not for everyone. Bryan lives by a daily routine produced by an algorithm, and he follows it to the letter. It requires him to take up to 120 tablets and follow over 100 health protocols every day.
Hyaluronic acid, peptide, you see the number of things I do every day.
He's also in bed by 8:30 every night and falls asleep in just 4 minutes.
So I wake up around 5 a.m. and then for 4 hours, it is just regimented. I'm on autopilot.
5 o'clock?
Or so, yeah.
By alarm or naturally?
Natural. Always natural.
After the break, the superfood that will change your life and make you live longer.
So it's the best chocolate you can get in the entire world.
In all honesty, Bryan, I'll definitely be dying before you.
And finally, the truth about vitamins. Do they really work or are they a waste of money?
Vitamin supplements, extra beneficial for anyone.
I'm pretty accustomed to offending just about everybody.
Just about everybody.
Bryan Johnson is spending $2 million a year experimenting on his own body, all to discover the fountain of youth.
In the morning, I would wake up and drink the Green Giant. So if you want to try that, stir it up a little bit.
Green?
I'll tell you what's in there.
This looks like the bottom of the Yarra.
It's collagen peptides, spermidine in the form of chlorella powder.
No, I'm Bryan.
Spermidine's in mushrooms, and it's a very common thing.
Thanks for clarifying that.
And I'll have this, super veggie, which is broccoli, cauliflower, black lentils, ginger, garlic, and then we put some extra virgin olive oil on it.
Mm-hmm. That actually looks pretty good.
Yep. And then chocolate. So this is 100% dark chocolate, undutched, high polyphenol count. So it's the best chocolate you can get in the entire world. Mm. So why don't you try that?
Well, I finally found something that's something that approaches what I would be eating.
Yeah, the chocolate's pretty bitter. It's a surprising pairing.
Are you saying this is for breakfast or?
That's breakfast.
This is breakfast?
Yeah. My mom always told me to make sure I eat my veggies before anything else.
Veggies with chocolate?
Yeah.
It's sort of a bit weird, isn't it?
What's not weird that I do?
I'm glad you said that. I can tell you in all honesty, Bryan, I'll definitely be dying before you. There's no doubt about that.
Collagen peptides.
Bryan puts every experiment, every result, online for free, allowing his fans to follow his teachings.
I put Bryan's protocol to the test, and frankly, the results have blown my mind.
But some of his experiments might be considered too extreme for some.
Apart from the strict regime that you follow each and every day, you have tried some fairly crazy things.
Hey, good morning.
I thought it would be pretty epic if my son, my father, and I completed the world's first multi-generational plasma exchange.
The blood transfusions.
Yeah.
For example, with your son and your father.
Chris.
Hi, Chris. How are you?
It came about because my father was telling me that he had become aware of losing part of his mental acuity. He's 70 years old. So he said, Bryan, I have to tell you, when you start losing your mind, you don't realize it. He said, I thought I would notice it. I'd be like, oh, I'm not as sharp as I used to be, or I'm missing this or that. You don't know it, which makes sense. And I said, Dad, I would do anything to help you keep your mind. And so I said, hey, we're doing this plasma exchange thing. Like, I'd be more than willing to donate plasma to you. So it generated from a place of me loving my father, of wanting to help him in keeping his mental acuity.
Have you noticed any difference?
Me, I haven't. Him, he has.
He has noticed.
Subjectively, it's been a significant boost, yeah.
Okay.
We're waiting for the data, though.
What about your son? When you went to him and said, look, how about giving us a bit of blood?
He raised his hand. We were just talking about it as a family. He's like, hey, like, that's cool. So a lot of people have these conceptions that, you know, and I've played around with this, like that he's in a dungeon and like I'm harvesting his plasma. Like he has as good of a sense of humor as anybody. On his social media account, it's listed as Blood Boy. Hit me up, I'm your Blood Boy. So it's a family thing. We saw it as something that was like a family endeavor. The media's had a lot of fun with it, which is cool.
Well, normally it's the other way around, right? It's your kids bleeding you dry.
That's really good. Thank you, that was really good.
This is a multi-spectral imaging device, and it shows you things the naked eye can't see. So this is how I got my children to wear sunscreen. I would tell them to wear sunscreen when outside, and they'd be like, Dad, enough. And then I showed them their face and their UV damage, and then they said, okay, we will wear sunscreen. It's alarming and terrifying because your face looks like a zombie.
When you say you're the most measured person in history, how do you do that with most of your organs? So you're talking constant MRIs or?
That's right.
Photographs?
Yep, so we use biofluids, which include blood, saliva, stool. We do imaging, MRI, ultrasound, devices, and then fitness tests. So like, for example, recently in a fitness test looking at how my body utilizes oxygen, I rank in the top 1.5% of 18-year-olds. I'm competitive with an 18-year-old on my body's ability to utilize oxygen. So it doesn't matter how you poke a blueprint, the data is pretty compelling that what I'm doing has really meaningful effect.
But you say that, and you take all these vitamins and supplements. Now, I've never seen comprehensive, conclusive scientific data that says vitamin supplements are extra beneficial for anyone.
Right. Yeah.
And yet you swallow them by the dozens.
But if only we could get access to the most measured person in history, and if only we could get access to their data, that might provide some insight. This is what I'm saying. I hear your argument. Oh. I've published all my data, and we show the organs before, we show them organs after, we show what things change. So somebody can make that argument, but you now can't ignore that I've done it.
From all your experience, let me ask you this. Right now, what would you say to the rest of society as to what is the worst thing that we do?
We are addicted to addiction. When you came here today, you drove by 30 fast food chains, 30 places selling you sugary drinks. You have junk food everywhere. You can get on your phone and do infinite scroll at any time. You got porn, you have digital entertainment up until all hours of the night. You don't exercise, you're not going to prioritize sleep. Like, how do we expect any human to not become addicted to the system we have? It's crazy.
Can I just ask you, just a question without notice. You've got a barbecue.
Yeah.
But you're a vegan.
I've never used it, not once.
Okay,
I don't even know if it turns on. I mean, there's a whole bunch of spider webs here.
Okay.
I've never tried to turn it on.
That's sacrilege in Australia. You know that, don't you?
Yeah.